Hey everybody, welcome to our Functional Core 1 video. First thing we're gonna do, just get in our mats and we're gonna march in place. Everybody try to stay with me. How we looking, good?
We're good.
A professional outfit, great. Excellent. Everybody, Amanda, by the way, is 9.5 weeks pregnant?
Yep.
Is that right? Excellent.
Great.
She's got her doctor's permission to do this exercise routine up to 20 weeks. You wanna pay attention at 20 weeks, how things go from there. Monitor your heart rate after that point. So she can do all the exercises we're going to do today, but if anything's uncomfortable, she's just going to let us know, all right? Brad's been doing a lot of workouts for a while, and Beth, obviously, in very good shape. So we'll see how things go. And remember, all the exercises we're going to do in this routine are challenging. That's the point. We don't want you to go to an exercise routine and make it easy. If it's easy, you're not going to accomplish anything. However, that means all of us can exercise at a different ability level. So if you find something that seems difficult, we'll show you how to de-intensify it. If there's something you think you want a little more challenge, we'll show you how to make it a little more difficult. Remember, do this at your own pace, and don't worry about the numbers, okay? Reps aren't important, it's making sure you do something to your maximum ability. Okay, now let's try to jog in place. Everybody still with me? Okay, we've got two ladies in the video, so I expect them to get a little funky on the jog, make it look good. A little boxing routine. The whole point is just to get loose. You can mix it up, run around in circles in your mat if you want to, kick. Do whatever. Very nice. Everybody's mixing it up. Oh, Brad's doing some butt kickers back there. Sweet. Nice. Shake your arms out while you're jogging a little bit. Loosen those up. And we're going to do some lunges in this routine. So the next thing we're going to do is actually do some lunges just to warm up. Get our legs used to that kind of exercise. How's everybody feeling? Good?
Good.
All right. I want you to go into labor here in the workout. A little premature. Okay, here we go. Everybody want to stand on the end of your mats. You can stand on the back. Beth can stand on the back, all right. Take one walking lunge. Important on a lunge, step forward, everybody. Come down and come back up. Turn around, take the opposite leg, and lunge again. I'm gonna show everybody what I want them to do in these lunges. Make sure when you come down, you wanna try to keep your knee above your ankle. Very good, Amanda's got a perfect form. Same thing with Brad. Knee straight up and down, good job, Beth. Very good. Everybody do 3-4 more of those. I'll join you, here we go. Down, keep my knee straight, turn around, down again. Okay, turn around, excellent. And one more. Nice job, everybody. The other thing to concentrate on the lunge is try to keep your back leg as straight as possible. The looser we get, that'll be easier to do. Okay, now we're gonna do a hanging hamstring stretch. Just put your legs wider out, a little bit wider than your shoulders. Lean forward, take a deep breath. And exhale. You can cross your arms, rest your forehead on your arms if you want to. Let your arms stretch down to the floor. The point is to stretch out those hamstrings in the back, okay? Take a deep breath in. And when you exhale, really feel that stretch. Deep breath in. Exhale. Getting a great shot of Brad's and my male pattern baldness right here. That front camera, excellent. Very good. Okay, everybody come up. Slowly lift that head up first and come back up. Now we're going to do a standing quad stretch. If anybody needs a chair, we'll get a chair, but let us know if you can do this from a balanced position. Take your left ankle, pull it up with your left hand, and just get your right hand out and balance if you have to. If you come out of it, that's fine. I don't want you to get down like this and get crazy. Just stand straight up and gently push your foot down towards the floor, okay? And all that does is stretch this quadricep muscle out here. Very important. Stretching is a huge part of what we do. A lot of people don't stretch properly. I stretch every single night and every single morning and before and after every workout. It's critical. Flexibility and lengthening your muscles will prevent injury and actually increase your performance. Let's get the right quad going here. A little less coordinated on my left leg. Very good. Another thing to do, it's just as important as stretching, is stay hydrated. You want to make sure you drink water before and, if possible, during your workout and afterwards. Avoid sports drinks. I just want to tell you that right now. Unless you're exercising for more than an hour in an endurance performance, you do not need to put sport drinks in your body. It's just extra high fructose corn syrup and calories you don't need. Water is sufficient. Okay, now everybody get to a push-up type position, and we're going to do downward dog, okay? This is an important stretch. It stretches your shoulders. Everybody keep your hands underneath your shoulders. Don't put them too far in front of you in the push-up position. And now just simply push yourself back up on your feet. The objective here is to try to push your heels to the floor. Remember to breathe here. Keep your fingers spread wide apart. Really push your shoulders down. Try to put your head down to the floor and get your butt up in the air. Push your butt towards the ceiling. Very good, Beth. Excellent. Everybody's doing a nice job there. Works your hamstrings, works your lower back and your shoulders. Everybody take three more deep breaths. On that exhale, I really want you to push that stretch out. Nicely done. One more breath. Good. Thanks, Jeremy. That's a good shot. Amanda's got good form there. Okay, everybody get up again. We're going to do alternating yoga reach stretch. Put your feet together like this. If this is not comfortable, you can put your feet wider apart. That's okay, but I like to put them together if you can. Put your left arm up in the air. Reach for the ceiling and kick your left hip out. And I want you to look right up through your left elbow, right through the ceiling. Get that chin up through that elbow. And again, breathe. You'll feel this stretch literally from your fingers all the way down your arms, your back, into your abdominal section. It's a great prep stretch exercise. About 20 seconds per hold is all you need to do. If you feel like you haven't got it quite stretched out, do it again. All right, right arm up in the air. Do the same thing, kick that right hip out. Amanda, nice job. Brad, well done. Brad, turn your palm towards the floor. Well done. Now look right up to that elbow. Look at Beth, got the finger point, the whole yoga point thing working there. Excellent. Good breath. Nice job, everybody. Okay, great. How are you feeling? Good. Good? Mm-hmm. Now we're going to loosen up our shoulders a little bit. Shoulders are involved in this routine. So I'm going to do small shoulder circles. Just get your arms out like this, palms up in the air, and just rotate your arms forward like this in small circles. Now, I want your shoulders to burn here. I want you to feel the blood pump in your shoulders. So when you get to the point where you feel like, oh my gosh, I wish he'd stop, that's when we've hit what we need to hit. Okay. I've got a little clock in front of me that I can watch. Make sure we're doing this in the right amount of time. Make sure you keep breathing. You can keep moving your legs if you want to, moving around a little bit. Okay, now I want you to rotate the other direction. Very good. Okay, now I want you to actually put your hands down and swing like this. Have you ever looked more silly? And on a camera. Nice. Now you're going to feel this exercise right up in here in your neck, all the way down through here and up in your upper part of your shoulder. That's where we want you to feel it. Getting everything loose. Now rotate your shoulders forward. Same thing. Big circles. Nice job. Okay. It's a swimming move. I hated butterfly. Can't do it. Can't do it. All right. I think we're ready to move on to our first exercise. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is called the squat Y press. Now, for some of us, you might want to grab a dumbbell. I'm going to demonstrate this with dumbbells. If you're not comfortable using a weight, you don't have to. Again, I think the goal here is try to do 10 reps of this if you can. If you get to 7 and feel taxed, you can stop. If you want to go to 15, that's great. Shoulder width apart. I'm actually going to demonstrate one from the front, and then I'm going to turn to the side. Keep your dumbbells down by your side like this. Go straight down. Keep your back straight. Get your butt about 45 degrees or 90 degrees off the ground. Come back up, and then simply put your dumbbells up in the air like this. Everybody got that?
Got it.
I'm going to demonstrate one like this. You guys can start when I start on this one, too, and show the camera how your back's supposed to be. Are you ready? And down. Come straight back up. Put your dumbbells up into a Y press. Very good. Come back down, and down again. Nice job, everybody. That's two. How's everybody feel?
Good.
Good. Come back down. Anybody know what number we're on?
This is four.
Very good. Five. Very good. Six. Seven. Everybody's doing a great job. Perfect form, you guys. Well done. See, I get to stop. You guys have to keep going.
You just count.
Okay, do two more. This is a great warm-up. We got our lower body, our legs, and our shoulders involved here. Everything's feeling nice and loose. Okay, great. The next exercise we're going to do is called the Spider-Man push-up. I'm going to show how to do this a regular way and a modified way. You can do this from your knees. Everybody get down into a push-up position. Start on the ground. If you want to get on your knees, you can do that. When you come up, all I want you to do is bring your knee up like this. Come back down and switch sides. It's like Spider-Man climbing up a wall. If you want to do it with your knees on the ground, it's fine to do it as well. Now, if you can only do 5 or 10 of these, That's great. If you want to drop down to your knees and do a couple more, perfect. Don't worry about the number, just do as many as you can. Ready? Let's begin. One, up, knee up, down, up, knee up, down, knee up. Very good. Very good. How are we doing? Look at Beth and Amanda doing full-on push-ups. It's crazy.
For the first few.
Now, I happen to know that Brad did a chest workout yesterday, so he is dying right now. He is dying. Good job, Amanda. Great job. Excellent. Amanda, I want you to get your head up a little bit more and try to get your chest down rather than your chin. Beth is doing a full-on excellent push-up. You getting that, Jeremy? Nicely done. Good job, everybody. Wow, I'm kind of impressed here. That's why I stopped. You guys were going to do more than I was going to do. Well done. Excellent. Now, don't goose yourself right at the beginning here. If you feel like you're getting taxed, you can actually stop. That's great. Well done, everybody. Perfect. Beth, that's a monster push-up. I'm serious. You've been doing some homework. Well done. Okay. Now, the next exercise we're going to do is called a floor to a shelf. Now, what I want you to do is everybody stand up, okay? Stand in the middle of your mat, and I want you to imagine that you have a ball, okay? We're going to do the first couple of these without a weight. If you feel like you want to stop and pick up a dumbbell and try this, it's actually fine to do. Okay, I'm going to use a weight just so you show what it looks like. We're going to go to the left with a lunge, go down like this if without a weight, and then we're going to pick it up and put it on a shelf. Now, if you notice when I do that, I'm engaging my whole core. I'm twisting my lower back, my legs, my hamstrings. And then we're going to switch to the other side and rotate those. We're going to try to do 10 each side. That sound good, everybody?
Sounds good.
Okay, great. Start in the middle. We'll go to the left first. Ready? Begin. Down the lunge. All the way down. Pick it up. Put it up on the shelf. Step back up forward like this. Down to the right. Pick it up. Put it up on the shelf. Step back up. That's one. Down. Oh, best going for the weight. Good. Well done, everybody. All right, I missed my putting on the shelf. Let's go to the right now. Here we go. Down. Pick it up. Put it on the shelf. Bring it down and step back up. All right, everybody. Good job. Oh, man, it's going for a weight, too. Everybody go to the left. Here we go. To the left. Down. Pick it up. Put it on the shelf. Excellent. Put the weight down your shoulder and then step back up. To the right. You guys are rock stars. Well done. Now, remember, you don't have to use a weight to do this. Left side. Excellent. Good job, everybody. Come back up. I think that's five. Let's do five more. To the left. Good job. Well done. Perfect form, you guys.
Should our eyes follow the weight?
Follow the weight with your eyes. Exactly. Good job, Brad. That makes it look like we know what we're doing. Well done. Perfect, everybody. Nice job. Is your mat slipping a little bit, Amanda?
Yes.
If it is, we can watch that as well. Let's be careful about that. Okay, great. How's everybody feel? Is that good?
Good.
One more? Way to go, Brad. Excellent. Okay, now we can put the weights down. Okay, now we're going to do another core exercise. We're going to lay down on our mats, on our back. Actually, I'll tell you what, lay down on your stomachs first. Why don't we do that? Here we go. Now we're going to do what's called a Superman to a boat. So Superman, otherwise we call these the Brads. Right, Brad?
Nice.
Put your hands in front of you. And what I want you to do is make sure that your head stays down. I do not want your head to come up like this. It's bad for your neck. The objective is get your feet and your hands off the ground as high as you can. We're going to hold it for a few seconds in my side. In fact, everybody make sure you scoot to the right side of your mat. Down like this. Up. One, two, three, four, five. Now roll around your backs and get up into a boat like this. Very good. One, two, three, four, five. Roll back on your stomach. Everybody up. One, two, three, four, five. Roll back on your backs. Everybody up. One, two, three, four, five. Back on your stomachs. One more time. One, two, three, four, five. On your backs. Everybody up. Try to get your hands. There you go. Everybody's got perfect form. One, two, three, four, and five. Okay, everybody stand up. Okay, stationary side skaters. Now, all I want you to do is to stand in the middle of your mat. This is an exercise when we do in our cardio workouts. We actually add a little movement to it. But this one, I want everybody to stay stationary. Put your right leg out like this on your toes. And all I want you to do is imagine you're a Zvitas speed skater. I'm from Wisconsin, so Dan Jensen's from our neck of the woods. We used to watch this all the time. All I want you to do is go down, one arm forward, one arm back, and come back up. Everybody got that?
Yep.
Okay, we're going to do 10 of these on each leg. Ready? Here we go. One, and two, and three. Why is this important? Our hamstrings, our quads, our abs, everything's engaged. Six, I think that's six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Everybody feeling good?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do our right leg. Here we go. Same thing. Get that left foot out a little bit like this and reach down. And one, and two, and three. Very good. Four, five. Now look at Brad's right knee. Check that out. Did you get that, Jeremy? He's shaking. That's good. That's called proprioception. His body's saying, what are you doing? And his whole body, his core, everything is trying to figure out how to balance himself. That's excellent. Two more. Very good. This may not seem like a big exercise, but your quads and your hamstrings are on fire. Okay, everybody back down your mats. We're going to get into a push-up position, okay? We're going to do a push-up to a side stand. I'm going to demonstrate on my right hand first, okay? So everybody get down to a push-up position like this. And if you want to, again, you can do this from your knees. Go up to a full push-up like this, and then I want you to rotate out like this and just point up in the air, okay? So we'll do right side, left side. Each one counts as one. Here we go. One, up, good. Back down, up, good. And back down, up.
Is it okay if you can't stack your feet?
It's very fine if you can't stack your feet. I'm not a big foot stacker, but I do it once in a while. Up, there you go. Up again, good. Now, I just cheated there. If you notice, my butt sagged down. Your whole point is to get that butt up in the air. I got people in the set over there saying, get your butt up. Brad's got perfect form. Keep that straight, see? I was cheating. Pathetic. Up again. Good job, guys. How's everybody doing? Brad, you got it dialed in just right. Good job, Beth. You too. How's everybody feeling? Now, Amanda, next time we do a push-up, I don't want you to go to your knees and get deeper.
Okay.
Go all the way down, okay? Beth, you're scaring me.
Yeah,
I don't think your husband can do push-ups like that. I guarantee you can't.
Yeah, we'll go to the knees for these.
Those are perfect. Well done. Okay, let's hop up. Now, this is a little bit of a cardio exercise here, but we're not going to do it at a cardio pace. We're going to do a thing called knee to elbow. Put your hands up above your head like this. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to bring our left knee up to our right elbow. And we're going to do this for 25 times. Everybody got me?
You got it.
Good. Mm-hmm. All right. Left knee to right elbow. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I get to 10, 8, 9, 10. I pick up the pace a little bit. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. I got five more in me. 3, 4, 5. I'm going 30. 1, 6, 8, 29, 30. Good job, everybody. How you feel? Good?
Good?
Everybody feels okay? Good. Now, we're going to do a very challenging push-up. It's called the Sphinx push-up. First time I did this, every bone in my body cracked audibly. My kids could hear it upstairs. Lay down on your chest. Okay, you're going to scoot back on your mats a little bit. Now, I want your elbows underneath your shoulders and your hands in front of you, okay? Scoot them up, get your elbows kind of tucked in like this. Very good. Now, I'm standing like a Sphinx right now. All I'm going to do is push-up like this and lock up my elbows, okay? Here we go. One, and down. Look at Amanda doing them. Two, and down.
Do it one.
How's the push-up freak over there, Beth, doing? She's doing them too. Oh my gosh, Brad, we really got to get our work going here, bud.
Right.
Brad, I want you to get your hands farther out in front of you, up here. There you go, dude. You got it. That's harder, isn't it? Oh, that's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Up. Try to keep your body straight when you're doing them. Oh, that's hard. Good job, you guys. How you doing, Beth? Down your knees. Fine, it's fine. You stop right there. That's great. You've done your job. You too, Amanda. That's actually impressive. I don't know too many ladies can actually do that exercise.
Yeah.
Look at you. You're tearing your mat up too over here, Brad. That's right. You guys got to pay me for this later. Good job, man. You're good. One more. Well done. That is great, you guys. I'd like everybody, if they could, to grab a dumbbell. Grab your lightest dumbbell that you have. Okay, if you notice, almost all of our exercises, we're engaging more than one body part. That's the point. So this next one we're going to do, we're going to do a lunge, and then we're going to get our arms extended, okay? So let me demonstrate this for you first before we start. I'm going to lunge forward. My arms are going to be back, and I'm going to put them up like this and bring them back. I'm going to turn around and do it again. So you want to grab as light a dumbbells as you can. If the dumbbells are too heavy, put them down, okay? I want form to be very important here. Everybody ready? Take a lunge with your right foot first. Lean forward, then bring your arms up like this and bring them back. How does that feel in your shoulders? Oh, yeah. Left foot forward, down, reach up, and put it back. How's everybody feeling? I'm going to watch you guys do this, okay? Right foot forward, lunge forward. Good. Excellent. Go ahead and pop in Jeremy and tape that mat up for Amanda. I'll have her step back while we do these over here. Nice job. Let's see if we can get some in the back there as well. Excellent, you guys. Now, when you feel that, when you're forward, your whole body is trying to keep that weight from falling forward as you get up to your shoulders. It's a difficult exercise. Good job, Brad. Good form. Nice job, Amanda. Good job, everybody. Beth, way to go. Perfect. Excellent, guys. Nice job. You want to get one more piece in there, Jeremy? Go ahead. Put it in the back there. I'm going to jump in here with you guys now. Here we go. One, step forward, up, and back. Nicely done. Here we go. Step forward, get it up, and then take it back. All right, everybody, one, two, two more, okay? Right foot forward, forward, up, and then back. Turn around, left foot, forward, up, and then back. Good job, everybody. Let's set those weights down. One more exercise, and we get a break, okay? Hopefully that mat won't slip too much for you, man. We're gonna be good to go. All right, now we're gonna do a plank hold. Everybody get in your push-up position again. Now, I normally would have said Amanda and Beth could do this on their elbows, but they're push-up freaks. If they want to, that's fine. I'm a little intimidated, to be honest with you. We're gonna get down here. We're gonna hold in a plank position for 10 seconds, three different times. Everybody get up to a push-up and begin. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Back down, rest for 3 seconds. One, they're Pete seconds, so they're very, very long. Two, I am the instructor, I can take my time.
Like those.
Two and a half. Three, back up, okay, here we go. Now, if you want to intensify this, put a leg up. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and back down. Oh, I'm ready for break after this. I don't know about you guys. How you feeling there, Mr. Push-Up 2 Day in a Row guy?
Feeling the burn.
Okay. Definitely. Back up. I'm going to go right leg up this time. Okay, right leg up. Oh, getting crazy. Another hand up in the air. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. And back down. Everybody hop up. Take a towel off for a minute. Grab some water, stay loose. Make sure you keep walking around. Oh, yeah, that's a good thing. How's everybody feeling? You feeling okay, Amanda?
Yeah, I feel good.
All right, good. Brad, you? You won't be able to shower for a week.
Yeah,
with
no,
your hands
right?
above your shoulder. I'm still kind of freaking out, Beth.
She's a machine.
Gotta keep my kids in line.
La machine. That's exactly right. You have kids. She's got a kid in college. Can you believe that? Scary. Doesn't look like it. All right, now we're going to go to a three-way lunge. Weights are optional here. Let's do it without weights at first. If you feel like you want to pick some weights up, we can. Stand in the middle of your mat like this. I'm hoping your mat doesn't move for you. And we're going to go to the left, we're going to go to the middle, and we're going to the right. And we're going to do that 5 times with each leg, okay? We'll stay with the left leg until we get all 5 done. Ready? Here we go. Left, one, up, forward. Good. And to this side. Now, the reason we're doing this in 3 directions is we're rotating our body again, using our core. To the left again, to the middle, and to the right. That's 2 complete sets. To the left, to the middle, and to the right. That's 3. To the left, to the middle, and to the right. Everybody's keeping their abs engaged here when they're doing that. I know I'm sucking mine in now. Middle, and to the right. How's everybody's knees feel? Everybody knees feel okay?
Fine.
Feel fine.
Good. Okay, good. Now we'll go to the right. Is your mat doing okay?
Doing good.
Great. All right, here we go to the right. One, back to the middle, and to the right. Now, if you have a knee injury, or if you have something that bothers you during this type of an exercise, you can mod it. You can stand, march in place. You can do a lot of different things. I had knee surgery this past summer, my right knee. It doesn't like some of these exercises, so some days are better than others for me. That's two complete sets on the right, back to the right. You guys all stand in sync with me even? That's a beautiful thing. Here we go. That's three. I don't know about you guys, but I'm working hard. And that's four. One more of these. Five. Well done, everybody. Good job. Okay. Now we're going to go with the side hip raise again. And I'm trying to think of the best way for me to lay down for you guys to see this again. Lay down on your sides. And this time I'm going to try to keep my butt up in the air, okay? Everybody ready? We're going to hold it for 10 seconds.
And arms up.
You can do your arms up, exactly. Very good. One, two, three, up. Arms up. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. And down. We're going to do one more on this side and switch to the other side. Up one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Good. Everybody switch your sides. I got to adjust my microphone to do that. Arms up. One. Now, if you want to get crazy, get up, pick a leg up. That's a little harder. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. And back down. Everybody all right? Up for 10 again. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Back down. Good. Okay, everybody back up on your feet. All right, now, the same kind of thing we're going to do. We're going to do a sideways lunge. We're going to put some weights into it and get our shoulders involved, okay? And again, we're not doing lunges straight all the time. I want you to turn and pivot to the side. I'm going to grab some dumbbells. You guys might want to grab some light dumbbells as well. Okay. Stay in the middle of your mat. All I want you to do is take a lunge directly to the side like this. You get down. I want you to pick your dumbbells up like this to the side. Okay?
Okay.
Everybody ready? We're going to do five on each side. That's it for this exercise. To the left. Here we go. One. Up. Good. Whoop. I fell out of my... That's okay. Come right back up. Now we'll go to the right. Right. Up. There's one complete set. Back up to the middle. And to the left, and up, very good. Everybody feel this in their shoulders a lot?
Definitely.
To the right, good. And up, that's two complete sets. Back to the left, up, back up, and to the right. And that's three complete sets. Back up, let's go to the left, up, and to the right, that's four. One more time, to the left. I don't like this because you all know what you're doing and I don't have to instruct you, which means I have to work harder. Back up and stand straight up. Excellent, very good job. We can put the weights down.
You got the heart pumping.
You got your heart pumping, that's good.
Yeah.
Everybody feel okay? Yeah, if you want to towel off, it's fine. Got a little sweat going, I agree. Take a sip of water. Back to Brad's favorite.
Push-ups.
Yes. Now, the next thing we're going to do is called a side-to-side fly push-up. Most people just do straight, regular push-ups. Your chest has a lot of muscles in it. You got to do different kind of push-ups to work different parts of the muscle. So, I'm actually going to do this facing forward, even though it reinforces the bald spot up here, and show you what this looks like. Everybody get down in a push-up position. And what I want you to do is go up, and then we're all going to reach over to the right-hand side and do a push-up with our hand out wide. If you want to watch me do one first, that's fine. We're going to go up, out to the right, and down. Now when we do that, see how much wider our hands are? We're working this part of our chest and the middle part here. Okay, now everybody start in the middle. We'll go to the right first. Now remember, just do as many as you can. If you can only do three or four, that's fine. If you want to drop to your knees, that's also okay. Here we go. Up one, off to the side, down. Come back up, put that right hand here, left hand out to the side. Back down, up, left hand right here, right hand out to the side. Up, very good. Now, man, I'm going to come over. You want to drop to your knees, okay? Okay. Now go to the left, get that left hand out, and go all the way down to your chest if you can. Very good. Right hand out. Now, if you want to, Amanda, pick your chin up a little bit and look ahead of you, okay. And that'll help you get your chest down a little lower. Perfect form. Way to go. Nice job, Beth. Way to go. Have you guys ever done these before?
No.
No. Do you like them?
Not really.
Not particularly. Very good. This is one of my favorite push-ups. My kids actually hear me groan when I do this one in the family. Daddy, what are you doing? Why would you ever want to do that? Good job, Brad. Well done. How's everybody feeling?
Good.
Nice form, everybody. Feeling okay, Amanda?
Yeah.
Great. So you're getting deeper. You're going to get a much better stretch and pull in that push-up than you do if you don't go all the way down. When we do our regular chest workouts, we use push-up bars once in a while, which really lets you to go deep in that push-up. This is an exercise you can't use a bar for, though. You guys are working very hard. I got to get down to some more.
There you go. 61.
61? 62? Very good. See, we have a camera on you. We can actually go back and check that. Well done, you guys. That's great. Okay, now we're going to do one that's kind of a mouthful. Everybody hop up on your feet. We're almost done, folks. We are almost done. Pick up your lightest dumbbell. I suggest it's very light. Okay. Now, this is what we're going to do. I'm going to curl up, I'm going to do a shoulder press, and then I'm going to do a tricep extension. Holy cow, the mother of all exercises. Everybody ready? Okay, left leg first. Lunge, come straight up, curl like this. Now do a Y press up like this, and then do a tricep extension. Oh, goody, 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 goody. Turn around. I'm going to go whatever opposite leg you did. I'm going right leg. Lunge, come back up, do that curl, up to a shoulder press, and then the tricep extension, oh my goodness. Back around, turn, I'm gonna go left leg. I don't know about you, my legs are toast. Back up, curl, shoulder press, tricep extension. Okay, we're gonna do two more of these. Turn around, lunge, curl, shoulder press, tricep extension, very good. Back around, last one. Lunge, curl, shoulder press, tricep extension. Very good, everybody. Now, obviously, if you get good at that, you can pick up the pace, you can increase the weight. We're gonna go to our last big abdominal exercise. This is called an oblique V-up. This is a challenging exercise. So I'm gonna lay here facing the camera. When you go to one, to your right side, you have to move your mic packs a little bit, all right, everybody? So lay down your mats. And I want you to put your feet and your toes pointed back behind you at about a 30-degree angle. Keep your feet at about a 30-degree angle, okay? And get down all the way down your shoulder, man. Put that left arm down by your thighs. Stick that left arm, there you go, okay? Right hand up like this behind your head, very good, because Amanda can't see me, I have to walk her through this. Now remember, I'm gonna come over and help you guys do this. If you can only do a couple, that's fine. Ready, here we go, up and back down. Very good, Amanda, you got it. Up and back down, good, up. Wow, you guys are awesome. I've taught other classes where they can't do it at all. Bending their knees all over the place, that means I gotta do more. You guys are doing great, well done. Up and down. And up, and down, and up, and down. Perfect form, you guys. 4, 5, 6, 7.
Are we going to the other side too?
9. Mm-hmm. Well, you can do 100 over this side if you want to. No, you gotta roll over to their side. So when you feel taxed, switch over to their side. Now remember, keep track of what you've done here for reps. If you've done 10, make that your goal for next time to do at least 10 and maybe 11 of them. Work yourself up to see if you can get in about the mid-20s, and that really starts to work your abs, okay? Left side, same thing. Everybody ready? Go. Try to keep those knees straight. Oh, it's harder on this side, isn't it? Yes. Great. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Amanda, that's great. My goodness. You too, Beth. You guys are doing fantastic. The first time I tried this exercise with my wife, we looked at the TV and laughed. Said, you've got to be kidding me. Great job, everybody. You're doing perfect. I really have nothing to offer you guys on that. The objective at some point is to touch your knees to your elbow, but that's going to be a progression. Good job, Brad. Amanda, nicely done. Beth, well done. Hop up, everybody. That's fantastic. Okay. We're going to do a single leg squat to a knee raise. I'm going to kind of ramp things back down in intensity after that last combination. So all I want you to do is put your right foot out like this on your left leg, bend down in a little bit of a squat, come back up and pull that right leg up, all right? Now, as you mentioned, if you wanted to intensify this, you could add weights to this exercise. With this kind of an exercise on one leg, it's not necessary, all right? We're going to do 10 on each leg. Everybody think they can stay with me? Here we go. Left leg out a little bit, down in the squat, come back up with the knee up. Two, and three. If you have to touch your foot down, that's fine. And four, and five, and six, and seven. You guys are awesome. Eight, nine, and 10. Very good. Brad looks like he's about to take off the runway at any point. Well done, everybody. Here we go. Right leg. Now remember, if you've got a bad leg, you can modify this. You don't have to have your leg up in the air. You can go down a little bit with two legs. Here we go. 10. One. Two. See, I'm actually putting my left leg down for this one. Three. Just to show you what it would look like if you wanted to modify it. Four. It takes a little bit of pressure off that right leg. Five. Six. Seven. Eight, whoop, nine, and 10. Okay, we're gonna do a side tri-rise. This is a tricep extension or a tricep exercise. It's gonna work your core a little bit too. You'll have to switch your mic packs around when you do the other side. Everybody lay on your left side right now. Can you do that? Where your mic packs are. Okay, take your left arm, wrap it around your right shoulder. Put your right hand right underneath your left armpit, okay? And all I want you to do is, in a sense, do a kind of a sideways push-up. And we're going to do, if you can do 10 of these, try to do 10 of them. If you can do more, feel free to knock them out. Everybody ready? Begin. Push up like this. That's one. Try to keep your right arm as straight as you can to get to the top. Two. Three. Let me see how you guys are all doing. Very good. Four. Try to straighten that right arm if you can, Brad. I know you've done some, a lot of push-ups lately. That's tough. There you go. Perfect. Five. Beth, you just scared the crap out of me. I don't know how you do that. Very good.
You feel that in the obliques too.
You feel that in your obliques. Yeah. Very good. You're engaging your core by doing this sideways, right? Rather than just doing a tricep exercise with a dumbbell, you've got your whole core engaged. Very good. One, two, three, four. Go whatever pace you feel comfortable at. Five, six. Remember, nobody here is competing with each other as far as numbers. Now, if you want to, that's a great motivator. If you've got a buddy you can work out with, a spouse, I can say spouse with my teeth, or a child or a friend, it's really motivating to help you do that. How's everybody's right arm feel? Good?
Good.
Yeah. Okay, now let's go to our right sides and get that left arm to have some fun. I'm gonna go this direction so everybody can see me. Okay, right arm up here over your left shoulder, left hand underneath your armpit, and begin. You'll figure out and one side might be stronger than the other one. That's okay. How's everybody doing?
Good.
We're fine.
I'm just trying to keep up with Beth. Killing me.
Beth is fading.
Very good. Man, you guys are doing awesome. Well done. Well done. All right, we're almost finished. Everybody hop back up. Okay, now, make sure everybody's breathing good during these exercises. Is anybody holding their breath during these? Exhaling?
No way.
Good. I'm sure you weren't. I'm sure everybody's breathing absolutely fine. Okay, I'm going to grab a dumbbell for this. You guys might want to do the same thing. We're going to do a squat to a calf raise. So I want to make sure we pay attention to our calf muscles during these exercises. I know your thighs and hamstrings are burning. We did a lot of great exercises for them. Again, I'm going to do this sideways just because I want you to see where my back is again in a squat exercise. Legs about shoulder width apart. Very important when you do a squat to keep your back straight. You don't want to hunch your back down. You're going to hurt yourself, all right? Come down into a squat. Then we're going to come up and simply just go up on our calves, all right? Okay. Now, try to do 10 of these if you can. If you can do more, feel free to do it. Ready? Everybody down. And up. Good, that's one. And back down. Two. Three. Hold that at the top in that quad or that calf stretch. Hold that at the top a little bit if you can. Very good. How's everybody doing? Good. Brad, try to keep your knees a little bit more forward. Very good. Make sure you breathe out when you're going up, okay? Time that breath. When you come up like this, that's what you should be doing. You can accentuate it and make it a little bit louder if you want to. Good job, Beth. Perfect. Beth's knees, I don't know if we can get a camera angle right here. You got that, Randy? Look at how her knees are perfectly aligned. That is very important. A lot of times, especially as a trainer, we watch people when we actually make them do this exercise. If they go down and their knees go like this or start to point, we can tell they have muscles not developed the proper way. Beth's obviously been doing a lot of cross training because her knees are just dialed in. Amanda, great form. Same with her knees. She's got everything dialed in. Well done, everybody. Good job. How many of you guys done?
Oh, 75.
Oh, nice, 75. Right. Okay, put these weights off the side. Beth's starting to scare me. Great. Okay. Now we're going to do a simple crunch. Everybody lay down on your back. We'll show how to modify this exercise too. I think we may have done this at the beginning or not. Put your feet in front of you, knees up in the air, lay down on your back. Now, a couple different ways to do this. I'm going to do a full crunch. I'm going to get my feet and my arms off, or my head off the ground, and I'm going to bend them both at the same time. To do a half crunch, just get your feet up and come up and keep your feet stationary. To take it down even more, keep your feet in the ground. Okay, everybody ready? I'm going to put my feet up. Try to do as many of these as you can. Here we go. One, two, put your hands in your chest, Amanda. You too, Beth. Three, four, five. Look at Beth doing full-on crunches. Crazy woman. Six. Amanda's doing the half version, so is Brad. Very good. Perfect form, you guys. Well done. Brad, try to pull your shoulders up towards the ceiling a bit more rather than your head. There, perfect. Nicely done. Well done, you guys. Excellent job. Nice. That's great. Okay. That's it for exercises. Now we're going to do a bit of a cool down. Roll over on your stomachs. Since we worked all of our core, we're going to stretch our stomachs out a little bit. Stretch out those ab muscles. Some of you can do a upward dog here. Some of you can do a cobra. Lay your feet flat on the ground if you can. If you want to keep your knees down, you can. Otherwise, you go up into a full cobra. Push up like this and just let those stomach muscles stretch out and breathe. It is very important during these stretching exercises to breathe properly. It's the same principle behind yoga. You'll actually feel when you exhale how much more of a stretch you will get out of those muscles. Deep breath in. Very good. Excellent, excellent. Okay, everybody get up on your feet again if you can. We're almost finished. Feet wide. We worked our shoulders a lot today, doing some dumbbells and presses. We're going to loosen our shoulders up a little bit. Left elbow just above your left knee. Let your right arm hang down and do a pot stir. Okay. You can go counterclockwise, or you can really mix it up and go clockwise.
I like to do both. These are my favorite
now. That's your favorite now? That's your new favorite exercise?
Yeah.
Very nice. Come back up. Put your right elbow down. And get that left arm going. We did this in 50 minutes, everybody, including all of our stretching. Who does not have 50 minutes a day to stay in shape, huh? No excuses if you can do this in your family room. No excuses I couldn't get to the gym. No excuses I have kids at home. Your kids can run around while you're doing this. Not a problem. Everybody get straight back up. Okay, we're gonna do some chest extensions. Palms up in the air. Just pull that chest back a little bit. Very good. Excellent. And I want you to take your left arm, put it in front of you. Take that right arm right up by the elbow and pull it towards you and pull your chin right above your shoulder there. Very good. Try to keep that arm straight, Brad. Very nice. Beth dialed in perfect. You too, Amanda. Nicely done. Okay, now hang it down. Right arm out and forward. Grab it like this. How do you guys all feel?
Great.
Good. Was that a good workout?
It was.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Huh? You got a lot out of it?
Yeah.
Good. I'm glad. Okay, two more exercises, stretches, and we're done. We're going to go back to our quads. We really worked these when we were doing lunges today. Take that left foot. See if you can stand straight up in the air. Beth is sweating profusely.
I am.
Well done. Remember, all I want you to do is push down with your foot, not necessarily pulling up with your hand, and stretch out this quad muscle here. Very important to do after we did all those leg exercises and all those lunges. Very good. Get that other leg. If you're wearing a heart rate monitor, your heart rate should be down right now. I wear one. We recommend people wear one at all times. Okay, last thing we're going to do is downward dog. We're going to stretch those hamstrings out in that lower back. Remember, keep your hands below your shoulders. Don't put them too far in front of you. And just push yourself up into downward dog. Try to touch those heels to the ground. Really reach your buttocks up towards the ceiling if you can. If you can touch the ceiling, let me know. If you want to, you can actually switch and stretch your calves a little bit out like this. Very good. And we are done. Nice job, everybody. You did fantastic. Well done, Beth. Super job. Way to go. Brad, nice job, man. Way to go. Mandy did great.
Thank you.